Aloha, good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. This is Master Paul, connecting with you for the first day of this beautiful week. We are in the middle of February. It is the 19th of February, 2018, and it is a Monday. And today, I'll be connecting with you to share with you more wisdom from Dr. Master Jigong Sha. And today, I'll be focusing on the soul. Specifically, the one sentence secret of the soul is the boss. I will share with you wisdom and insights from one of Master Sha's books, one of the key books that changed my life and put me on trajectory to aligning to my soul, to heaven, at a much faster pace. So hopefully you'll get some value out of that as well. So I'm very happy and grateful for your presence joining me today. And so this last weekend was a very busy one. Hang on, let me send a text to my wife who was calling me in the middle of my live stream. And make sure she knows. Okay. I have to put it on vibrate too so I'm not interrupted again. Okay. So thank you all for joining. This weekend was a busy weekend, got a lot accomplished. Hopefully you did too. Last weekend was filled with some pretty awesome live streams. We had live streams about the karma of being right, about how to open our love to ourself. There was another one earlier in the week on the 15th that I did for the Love, Peace, Harmony Connection, and it included wisdom from my Soulmate Karma ebook. You know, for Valentine's Day, I decided to do a live stream to assist that beautiful group dedicated to serving humanity. Now, there's a lot of people out there that are looking for their soulmates. So if you missed that, make sure you go back to my Facebook page and you can like and subscribe. And from there, you can locate me and locate that recording. But good stuff. And this week is going to be more good stuff. So let's see who's joined us so far. Welcome, Phyllis. Welcome also to M.A. Drade. And welcome, Paula Hyatt. Welcome, Jennifer Kress-Smith. And welcome, Sanjita. Aloha, Vanessa. Aloha, and welcome also to Angeli Flata. Welcome, Kristen Rojas. Welcome also, Kathy Arnold. Welcome, aloha, Michelle. And Linda Iloba. Aloha, Pat. Aloha, and welcome also to Nina Midway, Lisa Zarniak, and Sharon Dodd. Aloha to Svetlana and Larissa. Welcome Janice Crosby. Welcome Missy Dodd. Welcome also to Sherry Picard and Kamudi Sain. Aloha NNC and welcome also to Joanne. I think I've covered everybody. Kathy Monahan and Jovi. Thank you all for coming to join today's live stream. Thank you also for clicking on the share button and letting other people know about today. Welcome to also to Vanna Morris. You know, this live stream truly is a remarkable medium through which many people's lives can be positively impacted. So I'm truly grateful to the soul world and to the internet world, to the functionalities of technology that allow for this kind of service to occur, and to Facebook for providing this platform. Even though I get frustrated with Facebook at times, you can't complain about this free service. And it allows me to touch people's lives and benefit them. It allows me to bring Master Sha's wisdom to humanity. So got to show gratitude in the right places, right? So welcome also to Sherry White. So as we wait for Facebook to gather a few more souls, please let us place our hands together, soul light, soul service, hand position. This is like a prayer position. We drop the left hand in front of the heart center. Right hand gently pointed towards heaven. Welcome also to Julia Abbott. Let us close our eyes. I will call in the beings of light and set the energy field for today's wisdom teachings and blessings. Dear our beloved divine creator, all layers of the divine, the Tao and the source, all layers of all committees in heaven, angels, healing angels, archangels, lamas, sifus, gurus, saints, buddhas, bodhisattvas, masters, ascended masters, kahunas, and more. Soul of beloved Mother Earth, the moon, the sun, all stars, planets, galaxies, and universes serving the plan of the light side. Our individual heavens, teams, guides, angels, and saints. On behalf of all of those present, I bow my head to you and ask most humbly and most sincerely for your presence. We are extremely honored and grateful for the opportunity to be more and more conscious and aware of you in our life. Please further bless us to awaken that you are the 99% and that this life is just the 1%. Please bless us to fully understand just how much you serve and help us and just how much we need to realign to our soul and to the soul world, to all that which we have come from. Please bless us to clear our blockages and understand deeply how our soul can assist us greatly on this journey if we simply awaken to it more. We ask forgiveness for this in all lifetimes that we may have taken people away from their soul journey. And we ask the Source Soul Song of Love, Peace, and Harmony to please turn on. And as we chant Love, Peace, and Harmony, we invite all souls and all universes to please join with us, to chant with us, to offer their unconditional service. So for anybody new, this is a mantra. It is a soul song. It is a healing mantra. You can make a request. And you can also download it at lovepeaceharmony.org. Kristen Rojas is the unconditional universal servant that assists me. And you can always find this information in her posts. So keep an eye on her posts. So let us chant together to offer this service. Lula, lula, li. Lula, lula, li. Lula, lula, li. Lula, lula, li. Lula. Lula, li. Lula. 我爱我心儿灵，我爱自然人类，恩灵让耳目舌声，相爱平安和谐，相爱平安和谐。I love my heart and soul. I love all humanity. Join hearts and souls together. Love, peace, and harmony. Love, peace, and harmony. How? Thank you. At least on my computer, I figured out a way to mute myself when I'm coughing so I don't hurt your ear. So I'm excited about that. So welcome, everybody. Thank you for joining. Thank you for hitting the share button. And thank you for your unconditional service. Many beings of light came with this, just this initial calling. My face and my nose is itching like crazy, which only occurs when they are present. So welcome Diane Wooten. Welcome also to Sherry White. Welcome Deborah Anderson. Aloha Barbara. And Christine Bacol, welcome. Also to Jen Christie. And aloha to anybody else. If I have missed your name, forgive me. So today, we're focusing on the soul is the boss. I remember when I first heard this, it did not make a lot of sense. On a conceptual level, I mean, I understood it. It's like, okay, you know, I know I'm the soul, and I'm just having this experience. But if the soul's the boss, then why is my life such a mess? If the soul's the boss, you know, why did this and this and that happen, right? Why isn't my boss doing a better job? And so this is my initial thinking with my monkey mind and my infancy of understanding some of the understandings and basics of soul. For those of you that are not familiar with Master Sha, I think probably everybody is, but just in case you're not, this is who Master Sha is. And he has written over 20 books, 11 of which are New York Times bestsellers. And the one I'm going to be working with today is called The Power of Soul. Write it down. Power of Soul. It is a foundational book. It is the one through which you should build your entire understanding of your soul from. There is, when he started talking about this roughly 18 years ago, it was kind of taboo. It was talked about a little bit in certain corners, but you know, people categorized it and put labels on it because there was a lack of comprehension and understanding. Now it's thrown around like it's an everyday word. You can go into Walmart and buy something with the word soul on it. There's cars with the word soul on it. So it's very commonplace nowadays. But it wasn't back when Master Sha was talking about it. And in 2003, August 8, 2003, it's a very important date, the divine, who had been speaking with Master Sha for many, many years, the divine came to Master Sha and with one of his retreats, no less. Master Sha stopped his communication to the many hundreds of students and put his head on the ground and explained to the students, "I'm sorry, the divine, sir, I need to bow down." And he put his head on the ground, and the divine shared with him that today there was a meeting in heaven, and this is the date of the soul light era, soul light era. And this is the new era that the entirety of the universe is moving into. Now, one might say, okay, well, what does that have to do with anything that we're going through and that we're witnessing in humanity as a whole? It's important to understand that everyone's heard of the 2012 and the Mayan this and all of these things. But what people don't understand, I shouldn't say that, what a lot of people don't have enough information on is that history repeats itself. There are cycles in which there are a spiraling up of our soul enlightenment higher and higher and higher until we finally reach the top. Now, it could take a million years, could take a billion years, but we keep spiraling gently upward. And when we do that, we go through layers of upliftment. Not only we as humans, but humanity, the entire galaxy we're in, and so forth. And that's what we're literally in the middle of right now, moving into another dimension. And at least based on the information I've heard, it's not a snap your fingers and whoop, here we are in the new fourth dimension. Isn't that exciting? No. It is a process of a movement along the path, on the spiral upward through this trajectory on the way to full enlightenment. And so not only do we as humans do it, but the entirety of life does it. And if you think that happens without some kind of connection to the source, we're wrong again. So the creator, God, whatever you want to call it, told Master Sha that on August 8, 2003, the soul light era has been initiated. And along with that, all things soul move to the forefront. Because we are soul first and foremost before we are a human body, first and foremost before we are all of the things that we're going through. We are souls. When we return to the one soul. So everything is one, no matter how you crunch it, and we're all souls inside the one soul. But we have been so far from that, that in the process of evolution, in our return to the one soul, we go through eras. Master Sha's wisdom, he talks about ancient era, near ancient era, and current ancient era. And then they go through three cycles. And in these cycles, we go into very high levels of awakening and awareness, which is the one we're heading into. And then it basically starts again to bring up the next group of people that might be animals now. And they start in the cycle that we were at, you know, maybe a million years ago, and it brings them through the process on the way up and out. So it is a process. And it started August 8, 2003. From there, all things soul started becoming mainstream, including just saying the word soul. So the title of this live stream today is Soul is the boss. Checking to see if we have any new people join. Welcome, Heather. Okay. And I'm going to read some information now that you've had this preface from Master Sha's book, Power of Soul. And I really want you to hear a deeper version of this. At least half of you are familiar with this book or have heard aspects of this. But every time I read it, I get a deeper layer. So I'd like you to listen carefully. So these are Master Sha's words. This is the book, Power of Soul. Millions of people worldwide are searching for spiritual secrets, wisdom, knowledge, and practices to transform and enlighten their lives. Throughout history, there have been many great teachers, including Buddhas, holy saints, Taoist saints, healing angels, archangels, Indian gurus, Tibetan lamas, and others from many traditions and many cultures. They have offered great teachings to humanity. They have explored the ability of spiritual power to transform human life. I honor all of these great teachers. In this book, you will learn what soul power is, the significance of soul power, and how to develop your soul power, how to apply soul power for healing and for transformation, including transformations of relationships, finances, enlightening your soul, heart, mind, and body. This book also reveals the true secrets of how Jesus, Mother Mary, Shijamoni Fo, which is Shakyamuni Fo or Buddha, the founder of Buddhism, Kuan Yin, the Bodhisattva of compassion, and other Buddhas and all the major saints, how they were able to receive great soul power from the divine creator and the universe. They are great examples for us. In fact, every human being and every soul has the potential to receive the same soul power as these great beings of light. But there is a requirement to receive the level of divine soul power. You must offer unconditional universal service to humanity and all souls. To serve is to receive. The more you serve, the greater the soul power and the greater the opportunity to receive. So how is it that this person named Master Sha can go out and wave his hand and literally a person's cancer condition can dissolve? Within a week or two, they go back and it's tested and it's just gone. How is it that from across the globe, he can wave his hand and 2,000 people can have miracle healing? How is that possible? The answer is simple. It's called soul power. And soul power is not something that somebody just finds on the street corner. They have to receive it. It has to be given. It has to be transferred. Who does the transferring? The source does the transferring. The source transfers those kinds of powers to the other great beings of light. Master Sha does not claim to be one of them. He just gives credit where credit is due to the source. And he says, this is how you too can become a great being of light. No different than anybody else. All the great masters have taught us you can do this and more. They've all said the same thing. The soul power is the way to accomplish it. So he goes on to say, on August 8, 2003, the divine held a major soul conference in heaven. That day marked the end of the previous 15,000 year era, whose two major spiritual leaders, Nyuan Yangyang and Yuan Shichenjin, were uplifted to the divine realm. In this new era, it had lasted for 15,000 years, is called the Soul Light Era. In the Soul Light Era, the final destiny, there's a reason for it being called the Soul Light Era, so listen carefully. The final destiny is to join all souls as one. He didn't say all souls of humanity. He didn't say all the animal souls. He didn't not include the stars and the moons and the aliens. He said all souls. That's everything, guys. So it's a very big and important time for the universe. So how can we transform all consciousness to divine consciousness and enlighten all humanity and all souls? The process requires seven major steps. The first step is to offer soul healing, to remove the suffering of humanity and all souls. Remove the suffering. I love those words. Who doesn't want their suffering removed? But what we fail to understand on a very deep and important level is that soul can remove all your suffering and everybody's suffering. This is the teaching of the Soul Power series. This is the first book in the Soul Power series. Again, it's called Power of Soul. Heal the soul first, and the healing of the mind and body will follow. Humanity suffers at the physical, emotional, mental, and spiritual levels. In the human realm, there are countless sicknesses. A human being needs healing for all of these levels. A city and a country needs healing for balance. The world needs healing for peace. I honor all healing modalities. What I am sharing with humanity is called soul healing. Soul healing is applying the power of soul to heal humanity, animals, Mother Earth, and all universes. Soul healing can carry divine soul power to heal. When people are suffering, it's very hard to create love and peace and harmony for humanity. You know, people, they're just in their own world. Oh, my back pain, my shoulder pain, my shoulder pain, my financial pain, my relationship pain. When we're in our own world of suffering, it's very hard to have love, peace, and harmony for humanity. Every human being has a soul. Every system, every organ, every cell, RNA, DNA has a soul. Soul has the power to heal itself. This sentence is something that can go right into this ear and right out the other one. Because we have been taught that, yeah, you can heal yourself. Did you guys see that going in and out the air? Yeah, you can heal yourself. Some of us go, yeah, I believe it, but we're still not healed. So a lot of times, because it doesn't prove instantly true, we fail to recognize that truth. But soul can heal itself. Very important to remember that. Power of soul, okay? You can apply soul power to offer group healing. You can apply soul power to do remote healing. This book will teach you how. The second step of the seven steps is soul prevention. Of sickness, prevention of sickness. This is the teaching of soul power series, soul prevention of sickness first. So the one sentence secret, prevent sickness of the soul first, then the prevention of sickness of the mind and body will follow. Interesting, right? We're such a reactionary society, we deal with things after the fact. Some of us are preemptive, but we don't realize even our preemptive efforts are with foods or avoidances of negative energies, negative things that we know could harm us physically, emotionally. And these are very good preemptive things. But what is above our mind actions? What is above our bodily actions of our food choices? Soul. So if we deal with soul and soul prevention first, it even affects our mind and body positively. Soul can prevent sickness at the physical, emotional, mental, and spiritual levels. The Yellow Emperor's classic of internal medicine, it's the classic Bible, if you will, of the acupuncturists, of the Eastern medicine. And it states, the best doctor is the one who can treat sickness before it occurs instead of after it appears. The third step is soul rejuvenation. Ancient Taoism has great secrets for rejuvenation. Ancient Buddhism and Confucianism also have great secrets. Gurus, lamas, and other holy beings from all kinds of spiritual realms have great secrets for rejuvenation as well. I honor all of them. In this book, I will teach soul secrets, wisdom, knowledge, and practices for rejuvenation. What is rejuvenation? It means reversing. Rejuvenation means reversing the clock. Reversing time, reversing aging. That's what rejuvenation means, okay? You can apply soul power for rejuvenation. This is the third step. Third step, soul rejuvenation. Interesting, huh? This is the teaching of the Soul Power series, the one sentence secret. Rejuvenate the soul first, then rejuvenation of the mind and the body can follow. The fourth step is soul transformation for every aspect of life, including relationships and finances. This is the teaching of this series. Transform the soul first, then transformation of the consciousness of every aspect of life will follow. So let's spend a moment on this. Soul transformation of every aspect of life. Can you expand a little bit? What's an aspect of life? My job. You mean I can transform the soul of my job? Yes. What's another aspect of life? My relationships with my mom, my dad, my children, my spouse. Can you transform those relationships with soul power? Yes. What has been taught through all of Master Sha's teachings? Spiritual virtue, spiritual debt, karma, right? So if we have five good relationships and two unpleasant ones, guess where our karma is? Guess where our spiritual imbalance is? The teachings are, use soul power to transform it at the level of soul. Your mind and their mind goes through a metamorphosis. Your verbiage and emotional reaction, their verbiage and emotional reaction starts transforming. Therefore, transform the soul of the problems first, and then the physical world representation follows. The fifth step is soul enlightenment. Ugh, cute word. Everybody wants enlightenment, but we don't know how to get there. This is the teaching of the Soul Power series, the one sentence secret. Enlighten the soul first, then enlightenment of the mind and body will follow. Soul enlightenment is the first step on the enlightenment journey. On the soul enlightenment journey, we need to remove selfishness, ego, struggles for power, lack of humility, lack of wisdom and intelligence, heart wisdom, heart intelligence, not study wisdom, intelligence, heart wisdom and intelligence, lack thereof. To reach soul enlightenment, one needs great purification, releasement of attachments to things. It has to work out this way. I did all of these steps and I'm sure it's going to work out. And when it doesn't, the attachments create great discord, great uncomfortability. Whereas the great beings of light, they know it's for a reason. They just work with it and just ride it just like a surfer riding a wave. In this book, Master Sha states, I will offer divine soul downloads to purify your soul and transform your life. Many of you watching have received downloads and transmissions, but you truly do not understand what you have received. You just felt good for the moment. You may or may not have practiced with it because you probably just don't understand. I suggest you pick up this book and become more informed so that you truly grasp the value of what you received and work more with it. Welcome, Gary Dougherty. Welcome, Catherine. Welcome also to John Crowley. Welcome also to Barbara Moore, Peggy Blake, Master Allen. Welcome, Shakira. Welcome also to Don Robinson, Becky. Aloha, Christine Urban. Welcome, Lisa Belafons. And welcome to Karine Koto. Welcome also to Jim. And I'm not sure if I mentioned your name, Lisa Patterson. Welcome, and Zoki and Mamata. Thank you for joining. Thank you all for hitting the share button. After soul enlightenment comes mind enlightenment, which is more difficult to reach. It requires even more purification and commitment to be an unconditional universal servant. After mind enlightenment, you move to body enlightenment, where you have to heal all the sicknesses of the physical, emotional, mental body. The sixth step is to enlighten all humanity. Now you'll notice in these steps of soul and soul power that what is occurring is there's a definition of how is the soul the boss. Soul starts at original creator, which birthed all souls from original creator's heart. We are part of original creator's heart. We are all souls. Inside of us are billions and trillions of souls that are aspects of original creator as well. And all of these souls, from our RNA and DNA to us, to those saints and beings above us, and all the way up to the hierarchy of original creator, we are all in the process of returning We're in the process of rejuvenating. We're in the process of enlightening. So our enlightenment as an individual basis is enlightening our RNA and DNA. It's enlightening our organs and systems. Our enlightenment is assisting our neighbors, our brothers and our sisters and our parents, because we are uplifting the whole as we move through our enlightenment. Soul power is not limited to the individual. Soul power is a collective. And as Master Sha goes through these seven steps, you're starting to see it become a wider version of soul power. He goes from individual to blessing our finances, relationships, to rejuvenation, and then further, now he's expanding into personal enlightenment, and now he's moving into enlightenment for humanity. So understand that soul and soul power is not limited, even a little, to the individual. The sixth step is enlightening all humanity. It takes our greatest effort to purify and enlighten the soul, hearts, minds, and bodies of every human being. Everyone can be transformed to become pure channels to serve humanity and the divine. In July 2003, I was chosen to be a servant, as Master Sha speaking, of humanity and the divine. Shortly after this occurred, I was given a major task to offer soul healing and enlightened services to humanity. Together with his teachers and other servants, he offered these blessings through retreats worldwide. What is the purpose? To enlighten souls, hearts, minds, and bodies of humanity. At these retreats, they offered the highest blessings to enlighten humanity. At these retreats, great purification blessings were offered. So we'll stop there for now. If you'd like to read more, this was just the introduction. We're not even breaking into chapter one at this point, right? So give me some thoughts. What did you think of that introduction? Is that a powerful, powerful introduction of what is soul power? Are you starting to understand why the soul is the boss? Now for us, you, me, all of those that are on this live stream, we're working with our own stuff, right? Yes, I would love to make a difference for humanity. I'm gonna do what I can when I can, but that is about 2 or 3 hours a week. The rest of the time I'm dealing with my wife, my husband, my kids, my dog, my cat, paying my mortgage, going to work, getting off of work, watching my once a week favorite show, and the list goes on. And so we don't really have much time to go outside of our own agenda, our own world. That's okay. Master Sha in his deep wisdom understands that as we work with our own soul and purifying our blockages, we then are positively impacting all of those around us. We are positively making a big, big difference for everybody. So, how is the soul the boss? Well, you have to ask yourself just a straightforward question. Truly ask yourself a straightforward question. Are you, whatever your name is, right? Teresa, Bob, Mary, Lisa. Are you your soul? It's an important question. It might sound silly at the front, but ask yourself, are you your soul? The answer should be no. You are not your soul. You are Bob, Lisa, Mary. You are a personality and a physical body that has an identification. You have an ego, you have a agenda, you have attachments, you have a thing called life all around you that you are very much enmeshed in. If you were aligned fully to your soul, which is the boss, then life would be struggleless, would be free of struggles. If you are fully aligned, imagine that. A life that is free of struggles, where you have zero worry about finances, none whatsoever, just emotionlessly free. And it doesn't mean you're rich, you just have zero worry. You just know everything will work out perfectly. Your relationships are just beautiful. You are free of pain. Your health is amazing, you glow. Your skin is refreshed, you look youthful. There is not a point, any aspect of your life that is out of balance or not just beautiful. That's when you know you are fully aligned with your soul. So we are not our soul. Because if we were, we would have those conditions. The soul lives forever. It understands how to bring us to these conditions that I've just described. And there is great power that is being revealed to humanity through the soul, through the wisdom of Master Sha, to help us get to that point. But we have to learn to apply it. So Master Sha has brought these great wisdoms, and he has brought great empowerment through these books, through these downloads, transmissions, through the calligraphies, other empowerments that assist us with releasing soul-level blockages. So our soul is the boss, and at the same time, it's carrying messages. These messages are positive messages and negative messages from all of the life experiences. You, Bob, Mary, Jane, Paul, Kristen, Linda, Pat, we are this lifetime's personality. But in a previous time, we could have been known as Gerard or Lawrence or Sylvia. We could have lived in a different country. We had an entirely different personality at that point in time. Our soul carries all of those lifetimes of experiences. What kind of wisdom is that? Do you think that wisdom could assist you with your current life suffering? What do you think? It's obvious. It's a loaded question. Of course our soul could. Why then are we not paying more attention to attuning to our soul? Why then are we not devoting as many moments of the day as possible to purifying these blockages that are creating suffering in our finances, relationship, and so forth? The tools are available. They're in front of us. We simply need to apply them. Soul power can literally bring humanity, as stated the very first sentence, can bring humanity from healing and transformation of our life to entire enlightenment for all souls in all universes. The soul light era, the goal of the soul light era is to take every soul, all souls, up to original enlightenment. That's a pretty big agenda. So in order to get there, we truly have to align to our soul more. So the steps, very simple, starts with the first step is recognition that we are a soul first and that our soul is the boss. We can start communicating more with our soul. We can hear our soul if we pay attention. We can make better choices to align to what our soul's guidance is. How do we pay more attention and release some of the blockages that inhibit us from receiving clear guidance? Understand clearly that our soul and the beings of light are constantly offering us guidance. They're constantly nudging us in the best direction possible, whispering in our ear. They're constantly pushing little things off the shelves, putting the words we need to hear in songs. They are bringing people into our life that can serve us. And yet, I would venture to say that maybe 5% of the time we hear it. Maybe 5% of the time we acknowledge or recognize it. The reason why is because life has been entertaining us to the point where we are fully invested in this ego, in this personality, in this life experience. We're not invested and our soul alignment as much as maybe we need to be. Now I say that very loosely because I know all of us are on a dedicated path to awakening or you wouldn't be here today. So I say that not as a negative thing, but as a general statement, because if you were free of suffering or moving towards being free of suffering, then it'd be very clear you're on that path. So the wisdom Master Sha starts with is first know you are the soul, not this experience, this name, this personality, and all of these problems. The second thing to recognize is that your soul is the boss of clearing up all of these life blockages that it has been carrying for all of these lifetimes when different personalities experienced life. Your soul knows how to remove those blockages. Your soul knows what blockages and sufferings are in your life right now, and it knows how to bring about those clearings. It might not look that way to you when something unpleasant comes to you. Your soul knew that that was coming. Your soul might have even created the conditions in which that unpleasant thing came to you. Think about that for a moment. What if your soul created the conditions? in which something unpleasant entered your world. Why would your soul do that? Because it has the greatest wisdom and the greatest understanding that if you listen, if you pay attention, if you follow the wisdom and teachings of forgiveness, applying soul power, then you can release the karmic condition that came to you to be permanently released from your life, thereby removing the suffering. Because as you align more and more to your soul, the positive side of that is suffering is released, suffering is released, suffering is released. Doesn't mean it needs to be painful. It can be far, far, far less painful if we attune to our soul, if we allow our soul to lead our life, if we don't let our mind get involved instead of let our heart lead our journey. Meditation assists us. Very simple. Close your eyes. Be quiet. When you are quiet, your soul can clear blockages in your mind, in your negative mindsets, attitudes, and beliefs. When you are quiet, your soul can clear blockages in your heart, can release selfish desires, can release anger, resentment, can release guilt. Your soul can release these heart-level blockages when we are quiet and still. When we are moving through the world in our physical body, doing our work, doing our basic things in life, we can connect to our soul. Just consciously connect. Dear my soul, I'm listening carefully. Can you please guide me so that I have the best set of results today and whatever needs to be accomplished, so that whatever happens that I may see as negative, you help me to process through it with consciousness and with awareness, with love and forgiveness, Master Sha teachings. Master Sha says these same things in his own words far more eloquently than I can share with you. So it's important to pick up his books, read his books, get the audio books, listen to his words, because they carry extraordinarily high frequency and they clear blockages listening to them and reading them. They're just clearing blockages just reading it. However, we still have to deal with life when it's in our face. When we take the time to be connected to our soul, which we're going to do a practice shortly here, and we reconnect with it on a daily basis, make it a part of our internal, external, everyday consciousness, we are doing our soul journey, and humanity a huge, huge, huge service. Nobody wants to suffer. Nobody enjoys suffering. Suffering is a lack of recognition of our soul and what it's trying to do to assist us to get rid of that suffering. If we stay in that place, we are not aware. So this live stream today is about bringing you to the very clear awareness of the power of your soul to clear your blockages. It's not accidental that, you know, 20 books were written. It's not accidental that 11 of them reached the New York Times bestsellers list. It's not accidental that Master Sha is one of the most renowned beings on the planet today. This is all part and parcel of the wisdom that he was asked to bring to humanity by our source, by our creator. And so it's up to you to extend past your personality, past your mind blockages, to become further educated. You just keep coming to this live stream, it's not going to help you. It won't. It's like me feeding you fish every day. What happens if I don't come? You're going to starve. Okay? You must learn to fish on your own. You must be self-responsible. You must pick up these books, this information. You must attend other live streams from other masters, from other centers. You must keep yourself actively attuned to the soul and the soul world. And in that way, you are clearing the blockages. Now, it can be a little painful at times. Stuff can certainly come up, then you're not exactly excited about dealing with it. But know that once it's gone, it's gone forever. It's like pulling off that bandaid. You can pull it off slowly or just rip it off and then, okay, you're done with it. So it's the ignoring of these things that create pain over many, many, many lifetimes. Like it or not, this is the soul light era. And like it or not, the frequencies coming in from the heavenly world and the shift that all of humanity is going through, it's literally unavoidable. It will cause every human being on the planet, you included, to bring up that which needs to be purified out so that we can evolve, so that we can move towards enlightenment. It will happen whether you enjoy it or not. So if you can empower yourself with the wisdom and the tools to minimize that suffering and ideally eliminate it entirely, then you're far ahead of those that are unaware of this truth, because they are going to go through that suffering without this awareness, whereas you will have the tools. And as you apply the tools and become more conscious, less suffering, you will have those same tools to hand the others. This giving of this wisdom is supposed to be so that you can learn to feed yourself, so that you can learn to fish yourself. And then you then become the messenger to serve others. You then pass books on to others. You then teach others the soul wisdom. You teach them the forgiveness practices. You teach them where to find this wisdom at so that they can also evolve. And as a whole, as a one, we move forward. So let's do a practice for connecting to the soul and releasing some blockages. So everybody go ahead, wherever you're at, sit up straight, bring your back away from the back of the chair. And place our hands in soul light, soul service, hand position. It's a hand mudra position. This assists with releasing soul level blockages because it connects us to heaven and to our heart center. Place your left hand over your heart center, nice and relaxed. Close your eyes. Bring your thoughts and your mind and your breath into your lower abdomen. Take a deep breath in. Release, bringing in your thoughts and mind and breath into your lower abdomen. One more time. Release. One more breath. Release the day. If comfortable, please repeat after me. Dear my beloved divine creator, dear all of the beings of light who have come for this practice today, dear my beloved soul and my individual heavens, teams, guides, angels, and saints, my name is Paul Fletcher. Paul Fletcher, Paul Fletcher. State your name three times. I am extremely grateful and honored to connect with you at this time. I am extremely grateful and honored for the wisdom that you have brought to humanity and to me to bless all of us to release our suffering. I thank you for bringing this wisdom on the power of soul and helping me to further comprehend and understand how I have not been as aligned to my soul as I can be. I ask most humbly and sincerely during this practice for your blessings to remove the blockages, mindsets, attitudes, and beliefs, heart blockages, all of those things that are inhibiting me from realigning to my soul, its journey, and its highest service. Please bless me in whatever way is most appropriate. I am so very grateful. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Now continue. Dear all souls of humanity and one ling, all universes, I wish to sincerely apologize for this and any time that I or my ancestors have brought suffering to you. There is no excuse for any of the mistakes that we have made. I know that we could have brought to you physical suffering, emotional suffering, mental suffering, and even spiritual suffering. And again, I sincerely apologize. I wish to be of value to humanity, to help others to be happier and healthier. And I ask from my heart for your unconditional forgiveness. For with your forgiveness, I can be much more aligned to my soul and to serving this cause. I will not make the same mistakes again. Thank you, for your unconditional forgiveness. To all of the souls in all lifetimes that have ever brought harm or suffering to me or my ancestors, my loved ones, I offer you my unconditional forgiveness and release you fully and entirely of any spiritual debt that you have with me. I offer you this unconditional forgiveness so that you too can move towards enlightenment and that we can move towards oneness. I am very grateful. Thank you. Please continue. Now we'll connect with our soul. Dear my beloved soul, I love you, honor you, bow my head to you, and sincerely apologize for not aligning to you enough or fast enough in this life. I sincerely apologize for any additional karma I may have created for you on this journey. I ask forgiveness, and I ask for you to bring into my life in a gentle manner that which is needed to help me to clear these blockages that separate me from you. Please bring into my life those conditions to clear the suffering that I have been going through so that I can be fully aligned to your highest and wisest guidance. I am so very grateful. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And so now we will do a mantra for divine forgiveness with our own soul. And we will ask this mantra of divine forgiveness to offer forgiveness to all the souls that have brought suffering to us, because we need to release them so that our heart can more fully open. So our body power will remain the same. Our eyes will remain closed. We will visualize in our heart center the greatest love, the greatest forgiveness to all the souls that have ever harmed us. And we will be receiving great forgiveness from our own soul. For the sound power, we will chant divine forgiveness. So while we are chanting, visualize sending the greatest love and forgiving all of those that have harmed us and receiving from our own soul the greatest love. Let us chant. Divine forgiveness, 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 divine forgiveness. And now let us offer our love. Divine love, Divine love. Share your love. Divine love. Receive love. Divine love. Divine love. Divine love. Divine love. Divine love. Divine love, divine love, divine love, divine love, divine love. Divine love, divine love, divine love. Keep your eyes closed. Inside your heart, see your soul as a golden white light being. Bow your head to this golden white light being with the deepest love and gratitude. See how this beautiful soul has nothing but the greatest love for you, because your soul is directly connected to Source Creator Soul and only feels the greatest love for you. And it reaches its hand out, its light-filled hand, and places it on top of your crown and sends you a blessing. Feel the light from this crown chakra blessing from your own soul and the divine. See the light radiating from that beautiful being of light into you. Divine love, divine love, divine love, divine love. Divine love, divine love, divine love, divine love. Ha, ha, ha. Thank you. Bow your head gently to your beloved soul. Bow your head to all of the beings of light who have served you today. Bow your head to your beloved divine creator. Humility is the fastest way to align to your soul and to heaven. Ha, ha, ha. Thank you. So when you are ready, you may return and you can share amongst each other your experience if you've had any. I wish to offer my deepest gratitude to my spiritual teacher and father, Master Sha, to his original soul, to all layers of divine Tao and Source. I wish to offer my deepest gratitude to my soul, to my individual heavens, teams, temple souls, divine heavens, animals, all the beings of light who have served me in this lifetime. Thank you. So I wait to read some of your comments, and I invite you to learn more about Master Sha. Kristen Rojas has posted in her chats links to Master Sha, his website, and many different pieces of guidance and wisdom that can serve you on your soul journey. What is most important is that we do our part, not only for our own soul and alignment, but to make sure we're assisting others to be happier and healthier. So if this wisdom resonates with you, not only share this video, but share the links to Master Sha's information. Get some of the books. You can pick them up on Amazon used for a dollar or two. You know, go buy 20 or 30 of them and share them with people you care about. TV.drsha.com. There's so many different ways that you can empower yourself with this soul wisdom. Do not push it upon anybody. They may or may not be ready. They're not ready, that's okay. Ask them to give the book away. Heaven has a way of putting it in the right hands. If you share, then one out of three people may be moved, and that's one more person moving towards enlightenment. Okay? So let's see what some of the comments are. I see. Thank you, Kristen, for all your postings. A lot of gratitude. Thank you, Kristen. I appreciate it as well. Welcome, Janet. Welcome, Ram Sarup. Peggy Blake says, beautiful. Phyllis says, more tearing and deep yawning. Yeah, very good release. Tears of joy for the forgiveness and love, says Deborah. So much love, deep gratitude. Again, tears rolling. This was Sherry. Nina says, emotional. Thought about a friend who had surgery on the 15th. Hope he did well. Becky, wow, warmth, big time. Lots of energy movement. Shaking, very powerful, says Becky Lefave. Janice says, just came in at the end. Thanks for this blessing. She needed it. You're very welcome. Thank you, Master Paul. Can't say enough about this experience, actually connecting with his soul. Actually connecting with the soul until this moment. So very powerful. Great, Gary. So happy it woke you up a bit. Certainly go back and do some more. Very powerful experiences, Sherry. Thank you. Thank you. Very grateful. Heather says, this was so very emotional. She was flooded with tears and had crystalline light come into her crown. Yeah, we all got a huge blessing from our soul in the soul world. Our soul carries extraordinary power. We are truly oblivious to just how much power our soul carries. Our soul can bring miracle healing to people. All that's required is we recognize and connect more and more on a moment-to-moment basis with our soul. How? Pick up Master Sha's information. Learn, learn, learn. Practice, practice, practice. Receive the downloads and transmissions from the books. Do the calligraphy tracing. The tools have been made available to remove our suffering. It's okay to be selfish in the beginning parts of this. Let's remove our own suffering first. Then our hearts open. Then we can be of service to others. That's part of being part of the solution. But it starts with you moving forward on this path. So I am very honored to be a master teacher of Master Sha. I'm very grateful for this opportunity to serve you. I do offer individual guidance and counseling, individual blessings, crown chakra blessings, etc. So if you're in need of personal guidance, of course there's a small honor fee for that because it does take my valuable time, but it will serve your soul journey tremendously. So I look forward to serving you. This is the last week. If you're interested in awakening your spiritual channels and connecting to your soul, this is last week. You can join my 12-week Open Spiritual Channels program. So if you're not familiar with it, go to my website, scroll down to the bottom of the first page. You'll see it. It'll say 12-week program. And I'm in week three right now. And so everything's recorded so you don't miss anything. But if this resonates with you and you want to be on the fast path, that's a very efficient way to do it. So thank you, Divine Tao Source, Master Sha, all the beings of light. Thank you to all our souls, all of our heavens teams, countless bow downs. Love you, love you, love you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. All souls respectfully return. Gong song, gong song, gong song. So I will see you all tomorrow. Bye-bye, everybody.